The chance to work on 13th Age has been an amazing opportunity. It's been great to work with a fantastic team, to work with Rob Hinesu and Simon Rogers, who've been very inspiring and given us a lot of great guidance to make sure we stay true to the vision of 13th Age. Also had the opportunity to work with a fantastic team of composers, Marianne Fisher, Terry Ehrlich, Chris Nairn, and Tristan Noon. Also some amazing musicians, just who have really helped bring this music to life. I'm sure that if I started the project telling them how much work they're going to do, they wouldn't have signed it because they've all pushed themselves much harder than they expected.
When James first asked me to join 13th Age, I was super excited because it was the first time I got a chance to write fantasy music. It was something that I grew up listening to, and coming from quite a video game orientated background, it was perfect.
One of the things that attracted me to writing for 13th Age was the fact that, you know, this isn't a picture, this isn't to film. You're actually writing to a picture on a page, which was quite tricky actually, it really was tricky, because you've got to have a look at the picture and just imagine that this is, you know, something that's real, it's real life.
Musicians have done a phenomenal job in terms of realizing the music, and really it's the difference, instead of relying on virtual instruments and what we can do inside a computer, those live musicians really help bring everything to life.
When James played me back what they'd done, I was just, it was just stunning, really stunning. And every composer dreams of having live players on their work.
We wanted to do something incredibly good, to really set our stall out and just write the best darn album we could write. Something that would really get attention and get noticed. Tales Around the Fire was specifically written for the kind of scene where you're actually building your characters. So, just to get people into the world the first time, the game's not sitting there, people are rolling up the characters.
It was cool because I got to study old Renaissance pieces, stuff that you'd probably hear played in a tavern. I wanted the feeling of warmth and coziness. You know, you've come in from outside of the cold, there's people talking in the background, there's people drinking and laughing, and I kind of wanted to have that.
I had the opportunity to work on the main theme, which, while I wanted to obviously on one side conjure up the excitement of 13th Age itself, I really wanted a very swashbuckling and adventure style theme, something that really made people excited and made people just want to go out and play the game. In addition to writing the main theme, I wrote the themes for the icons as well, and the team really got behind that. These are particularly useful if you want to emphasize the effect an icon is having on a particular scene.
The most fun to write was probably the three. It incorporated three different themes in one piece, which was kind of nice because it just kind of it starts on something and then it goes into another theme, and then it breaks away from that entirely and goes into something else.
I'm exceptionally proud of what we've achieved with this album. We pushed ourselves much harder than before. We worked with more live musicians than ever before. I ended up buying loads of instruments just so I could throw them down.
The composing group was just really kind of intact, and everybody was looking out for each other. We were always in constant communication with each other, which is really important because you need to know what everyone's up to.
I really feel that this 13th Age soundtrack is going to immerse existing players in such a way that they'll keep coming back for more.
In the end, I think we've come up with something that I'm really proud of, I know my team's proud of, Rob's proud of. I think this is a great album, and I really hope you enjoy listening to it.